In lecture 5, we have discussed the resistivity with resistance with length and breadth, and also different expressions R proportional to L square some cases when volume remains constant, R proportional to 1 by A square when volume remains constant. They are all we discussed. Now let us see for a cuboid. For a cuboid, what is the resistance? So you take this one as a cuboid. This one as a cuboid. This is length. This is breadth. This is height. Length, breadth, and height. Length, breadth, and height. Okay. Now, this is height. Now, this is the left face A. This is right face B. Left face A and right face B. Now, what is the resistance now? R is equals to rho L by A. Rho L by A. Length by area of cross section. What here for left and right faces? Left and right faces. That is A and B. What happens? Rho. Length is L only cross section. This go like this. This comes out like this. What is the cross section area? Cross section area is B into H is the cross sectional area. Rho L by B H. Say equation 1. Now consider the top and bottom face. Let us say C and D. For top and bottom face. Top and bottom faces. Top and bottom. It is C and D. For top and bottom faces. R is equals to. This is R is equal to top and bottom. It comes like this and goes like this. Then what is the length here? The length is the height. The length is here. This is the length now. Then what is the cross section? This is the cross section. This is the cross section. What is the area of cross section? Length into breadth. Therefore, R is equals to rho. Here, height is rho h. Rho h by A. Rho h by rho h by area is L into B. L into B is the area. Rho h into L into B. That is equals to, say, equation 2. Rho h. Now, for top and bottom. Now, what is front and back? For front face and back face. Front and back faces. For front face and back faces, what happened? This is front face. This is front face. Let us say E. This is back face. This is back face. This is S. F. E and F. For front face. This is front face. This is going like this now. It is going like this. Therefore, what is the length becomes? R is equals to rho B by. Naturally, area will be L into H. L into H is the area. This is the resistance for the three faces. Now, if you consider this L greater than B greater than H, L greater than B greater than H. L is larger, H is smaller. Then this will be the maximum. L is larger. This is H is minimum. Therefore, this is minimum. This is maximum. This is minimum. Therefore, R max by R minima. What will get? R max by R minima. We will get rho L by BH into rho H by LB. Rho H by LB. Rho gets cancelled. BB gets cancelled. This is equals to L square by H square. L square by H square. That is the very important one in doing the problems. Therefore, resistance maxima in a cuboid. Resistance maxima by resistance minima is simply L square by H square. Into maximum length by square, maximum length square by minimum length square. Now this is another part. Now let us see the variation of resistivity with temperature and resistance with temperature. Variation of resistivity and resistance with temperature. Variation of resistivity rho with temperature, also resistance. It is given by R rho T. Rho T is equals to rho naught into 1 plus alpha into T minus T naught. Rho T is equals to rho naught into 1 plus alpha into T minus T naught. This here, what is rho T? This is the rho T is the resistivity at rho T, at T degrees centigrade, at T degrees centigrade. Now, what is rho naught? Resistivity at T naught degrees centigrade. Sometimes we take this one as rho T is equals to rho naught into 1 plus alpha delta T. Now, in some cases, we take T naught is equal to 0 degrees centigrade. T naught is equal to 0 degrees centigrade. Then rho T is equals to rho naught into 1 plus alpha T only. The rho T is equals to rho naught into 1 plus alpha T. Same thing applies for resistance also. For resistance, RT is equals to R naught into 1 plus alpha T, or you can write two temperatures are there, you can write delta T also in place of this one. You can also write delta T if two temperatures are given. If one is 0 degrees, then it is only T. Another temperature is given, you can take it as delta T. Remember, if other temperature is given as 0, it is only T. If it is given different temperatures, take it as delta T. Therefore, rho RT is equals to R naught into 1 plus alpha T. Now, I have not defined what is alpha here. I will explain what is alpha here. Okay. Now, from this equation, RT minus R naught is equals to R naught plus R naught alpha T. Is it or not? RT minus R naught is equals to R naught plus R naught alpha T implies delta R is equals to R naught. Here RT is equals to R naught plus R naught alpha T. This implies RT minus R naught is equals to R naught alpha T implies delta R is equals to R naught alpha T. This implies this implies alpha is equals to delta R by R naught T. Delta alpha is equal to delta R by R naught T. Delta R is equals to alpha is equals to delta R by R naught T. Here R is, what is R here? R is RT. RT is the resistance at T degrees centigrade. R naught, resistance at 0 degrees centigrade. Alpha, temperature, coefficient of resistance. Alpha is the temperature coefficient of resistance. Alpha is the temperature coefficient of resistance. What are the units of alpha there? Here R by R, delta R means resistance is ohm. R is ohm, ohm by ohm. Ohm by ohm into degrees centigrade. Yes, 1 by degrees centigrade. Per degrees centigrade. Units are per degrees centigrade is the unit of alpha. From this equation, alpha T is equals to delta R by R naught. Alpha T is delta R by R naught. If this remains constant for different and a given for different materials or for a given temperature, then what happens? Alpha 1 T1 is equals to alpha 2 T2. Alpha 1 T1 is equals to alpha 2 T2 is the very important equation in solving the problems. Now, as we know, R is equals to R naught into 1 plus alpha T. RT is equals to R naught into 1 plus alpha T. Now, here RT is the resistance at 3 degrees centigrade. Let R1 is the resistance at T1 degrees centigrade. And R2 is the resistance at T2 degrees centigrade. This implies R1 is equals to R0 into 1 plus alpha T1 and R2 is equals to R0 into 1 plus alpha T2. Divide. Let us say 1, this is 2. 1 by 2 implies R1 by R2 is equals to R0 into 1 plus alpha T1 by R0 into 1 plus alpha T2. Now R0 gets cancelled, implies R1 into 1 plus alpha T2 is equals to R2 into 1 plus alpha T1. This implies R1 plus R1 alpha T2 is equals to R2 plus R2 alpha T1. Implies R1 alpha T2 minus R2 alpha T1 is equals to R2 minus R1. Implies alpha into R1 T2 minus R2 T1 is equals to R2 minus R1. Implies alpha is equals to R2 minus R1 by R1 T2 minus R2 T1. If R1 and R2 are the resistances at temperatures T1 and T2 degrees centigrade, then the temperature coefficient of resistance is given by R2 minus R1 by R1 T2 minus R2 T1. This is per degrees centigrade. This is one of the important expressions. And a small thing, very important and very, very small thing is how alpha, temperature coefficient of resistance, varies with semiconductors and conductors. Now alpha in Kunam, alpha is a temperature coefficient of resistance. We call alpha as temperature coefficient of resistance. For semiconductors or insulators, very important thing, very, very important thing. As temperature increases, conductivity sigma increases. As conductivity is equals to 1 by rho or rho is equals to 1 by sigma, resistivity decreases. This is resistivity. This is conductivity. This is temperature. Therefore, for semiconductors, as temperature increases, resistivity decreases. Therefore, these are characterized by negative. Alpha is negative for semiconductors and also taken as insulators. Okay. Now, for case of conductors, metals. In case of conductors or metals, what happens? Temperature increases, conductivity decreases, resistivity increases. Conductivity decreases, resistivity increases. Therefore, alpha is positive for conductors and alpha is negative for semiconductors, because in case of semiconductors, temperature increases, conductivity increases. Therefore, resistivity decreases. In case of conductors, these are characterized by negative temperature coefficient of resistance. In case of conductors, as temperature increases, resistivity increases, because conductivity decreases. These are characterized by positive temperature coefficient of resistance. Now let us see in next class series and parallel and also graphical variation of temperatures with conductance and resistance also. That is also important. Thank you.